Make that push. You have to feel when you put your leg on it, she makes a good leg and hand connection. You're also feeling the fluidity of this thing. You feel like she's staying really open in the joint. So there's some more to the push to the bridle. But yeah, and close the hand there. Close the hand, hand steady, and then push it forward again. Good. You're going to shorten up the reins a little bit. Right? So I would say once she's where you want her, you might have to work a little bit to get her there, but once she's there, you just keep your hands really steady. And then she says, can I move your hands? And you say no. Good. Keep it. Keep it. Now a little forward. Make a little push. Make a little push. Hands together and quiet. Make a little push, like medium. Coming to the medium or extended. Go. Go. Good. And now you close your fingers and collect it back. Close the fingers. Keep the push in the hind leg. Sometimes when we go to collect, they get a little tighter bracing and we have to bend. If you feel her getting really tight bracing in the bridle, you might have to bend. It doesn't mean you have to throw it away. It just means you're telling her not to get tight and tense. You ever think of your horse as having a giant tube going through it? Okay, so what if we imagine we have a giant tube going through your horse's body? It kind of follows the spine. And on one end of the tube, where the hind leg is, it's a blower, and it's blowing air through the tube. Up where the bit is a screen. And there's a ball. There's a ball in that tube. Now you have to keep enough blower power, or air pressure, to push that ball all the way up to the bit. Good. Put the hind leg on the track. Good. There you go. I like it. What do you think? Yeah. That's good. Very good. Now, do you do much sitting?
Yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
Go sitting.
Okay.
Good. I like to hear that. You know why we do shoulder in?
No.
No? Not to amaze our loved ones and friends. Right? We do shoulder in because we engage the inside hind leg. We're putting the hind leg under your seat. Bring the inside hind leg. Right. So when's the best time for you to use your leg to make the hind leg step under? When her hind leg is coming, yeah. So that would be when you were out of the saddle when you're posting, which doesn't make it easy for you to use your leg. So now, 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 now. Keep it. Yeah. Keep it. Good. Keep it. Very good. Yeah. Good. So we use the shoulder in to get the hind leg stepping under your seat pattern. And then when you use your core, the half hour, you know what we get? More balance on the hind leg. You can make better balance on the hind leg because you're sitting tight and you can't get your right hand. Keep it. Keep it. Good. Hind leg under. Yep. Keep it. There you go. No, you had it. That was good. There you go. I need that much. Right. On the next long side, haunches in. Did you do haunches in? Your outside leg behind the girth. Good. Good. Now back to shoulder in. Right out of there. Pivot the forehand right around and in the shoulder in. Right. Keep the jump. Uh-oh, what happened? She went through the back door, yeah? Then you close your hand and energize the hind leg. Make your jump through. Come. Come. Make your jump through. Good. Shoulder in. Now hunches in. Push the forehand back. Keep the bend over the inside. Left shoulder in. Now hunches in. Just move the left shoulder over. Put the right leg behind the girth. There you go. Well done. Kind of a cool thing to do, isn't it? Good, very good. You're not rising, are you? Oh, man. You probably didn't think I'd notice. I'm gonna tell you a little secret. You're the only one out there. I'm going to know you. You can't hide. Unless you start wearing breeches that are matching the kickboards, I'm going to notice. The camouflage. Kickboard breeches. Good. Long side to the shoulder in, please. Uh-oh. Keep that jump in a hind leg. Yeah. Now that's one of the things the horse will do a lot. When you say, okay, let's bump up the workload and go a little sideways. And that's what it does, right? It bumps up the workload, makes him work a little harder. You know what they say? Oh, how am I going to do that and not work any harder? I know, I'll slow down. Now push her through. So if she slows down, then you have to quicken it. So if she said, I'm going slower, then you say, all right, then you get quicker. Yeah? If you want to slow down, then you're going to get quicker. You have to go faster. For a couple steps anyway. Back to the shoulder in again. Keep the jump, keep the jump, keep the jump. Inside high. Down high. Bend around your inside leg. Move the inside shoulder over. Good. And now back to your shoulder in. Keep the jump. Keep that jump. Good. Now hunches in again. Bend over the inside shoulder.
Good.
Long side, medium. Right from there, shoulder in.
There you go.
So now you take the forward and put it in to the shoulder in. Kind of cool thing to do. And again, medium. There you go. Now shoulder in. Bend and in the inside hand leg. There. Now you got a big forward thinking shoulder in. Very good, yeah? No. So, every once in a while, you might have to do a little forward, right?
Yep.
You might have to do a little medium. Now medium again. Go. Now half up the inside shoulder and haunches in. Half up the inside shoulder up and bring the outside out. There. There you go. Now back to straight. Right. Good job. Now diagonal. Change the rein. Let's try. And then I want haunches in on the diagonal. And then you ride both front legs, okay. Like it's your straight line, both front legs, okay. So we're looking over the right shoulder, now bring the left leg sideways. Bring the left leg over, take the bend over the right shoulder. Yes, take the bend over the right shoulder, bring the outside hind leg. Outside hind leg, outside leg. That would be the left hind leg, you took the right hind leg. Yeah, I hate it when that happens. Yeah, diagonal. Now you're going to use your outside leg behind the girth. That'd be your right leg. Both front legs aiming to the mark. Now bring the outside hind leg over. Make more bend over the inside shoulder. Keep the outside hind leg coming. Right leg coming. More bend over the left shoulder. More bend left. There. 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 Good. That's how you start a half pad. Half pad punches in on the diagonal half pad. That's it. Yeah. Punches in on the diagonal. Is half dead. Good. Good. That jump. Yep. Very good. How's it feel?
Good.
Diagonal. Now, which is your outside leg? The left. Now, bend right. Bend your right. Put your forehand on the diagonal. And bend the left leg over. There. Good. Good. Keep it. Keep it. Very good. There. Nicely done. There you go. And walk. So every time her neck comes back in your leg, and every time her neck and her head comes back in your lap like that, she's telling you she's taking too short a step. So you have to have a minimum length of stride for your step under you to take her balance and your balance in the same direction.
Sorry.
No, that would mean you close your hands and drive your hind leg through. So you're riding more energized through the neck. Make it go. So when she's saying I'm taking a short step, too short a scabby step behind, that's what you get. Okay? So when she says I'm going to go short, short, short behind, she takes her neck short. And you have to say go forward. Put your leg on and send her through the neck. Into the connection. Round her again. Tap off. Keep it. Straight alongside, make the push. Okay. So what we're looking for, the idea of having enough forward is that she takes a pull-up and a stride. So now we've talked about the idea of supple, that you can bend and move her where you want. Forward means that she really pushes through the bridle, and she takes a long enough stride to push through the outline. Good. Good. There you go. Good. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. Now half up again, a little rounder, keep the jump behind. Again. Now when she says, hey, can I push up against you? I close my hand, so I take back, encourage her to come around, and I put my leg in and say, push through the ear, push through the neck. Good. 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 Keep it. Close the hand again. Tell it, come through. There. Now if you close your hand and she brings her head back in your lap, you know what she's saying? I'm stepping short behind. I'm not taking a long enough stride. So when you think about the word forward, it has forward. Well, we keep the supplement, right? We keep the straightness. We keep that push forward. If you're not sure if you have enough push in the hind legs, close your hand and put your leg on. Push it through the ears. There. Good. On the diagonal, chain the rein through the trap. Right there, she came behind your half arm. You said come rounder, and she said shorter on the hind leg, and her head came back in your lap, didn't it?
Yep.
So there's where you have to think of putting the leg on, extending through the connection. Good. Think outside leg, on your right leg side. Turn the nose, start to mark. Okay, riding marches in. Then we're going to come out of the corner, far corner back. Right leg behind the girth, right? Right leg behind the girth. Now bend already. Bend over the left shoulder. Already you're bending. Ride the diagonal. There, now bring the hind leg. There you go. Keep the bend. Half hold a little on the inside. Keep the outside hind leg coming. Half hold inside shoulder. Make that push. You have to feel when you put your leg on, it should make you go to leg and hand connection. But also feeling the fluidity of this thing. I want to feel like you're staying really open in the joint. So there's some more to the push to the bridle. But yeah, and close the hand there. Close the hand, hand steady, and then push it forward again. Good. You're going to shorten up the reins a little bit. Right. So I would say once she's where you want her, you might have to work a little bit to get her there, but once she's there, you just keep your hands really steady. And then she says, can I move your hands? And you say no. Good. Keep it. Keep it. Now a little forward. Make a little push. Make a little push. Hands together and quiet. Make a little push, like medium. Coming to the medium or extended. Go. Go. Good. And now you close your fingers and collect it back. Close the fingers. Keep the push in the hind leg. Sometimes when we go to collect, they get a little tighter bracing and we have to bend. If you feel her getting really tight or bracing in the bridle, you might have to bend. It doesn't mean you have to throw it away. It just means you're telling her not to get tight and tense. You ever think of your horse as having a giant tube going through it? Okay, so what if we imagine we have a giant tube going through your horse's body? It kind of follows the spine. And on one end of the tube where the hind leg is, it's a blower, and it's blowing air through the tube. Up where the bit is a screen. And there's a ball. There's a ball in that tube. Now you have to keep enough blower power or air pressure to push that ball all the way up to the